हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल। टुडे वी विल डू एक्सरसाइज 6.2 ऑफ क्लास 8 मैथ्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डू द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट। सो फर्स्ट इज फाइंडिंग द स्क्वायर ऑफ अ नंबर विदाउट एक्चुअल मल्टीप्लिकेशन। सो इफ वी हैव टू फाइंड स्क्वायर ऑफ अ नंबर, वन मेथड इज टू मल्टीप्लाई दैट नंबर ट्वाइस, विच इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द स्क्वायर। बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट द स्क्वायर विदाउट डूइंग एक्चुअल मल्टीप्लीकेशन देन वट इज द मेथड। सो देर इज अ फॉर्मूला टू कैलकुलेट द स्क्वायर ऑफ अ नंबर विदाउट एक्चुअल मल्टीप्लीकेशन, विच स्टेट्स दैट ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर, दैट मीन्स स्क्वायर ऑफ द सम ऑफ टू नंबर्स। हेयर ए एंड बी आर टू नंबर्स, दिस इज इक्वल टू ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस 2 इंटू ए इंटू बी, वेयर ए एंड बी आर टू नेचुरल नंबर्स। सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट सम ऑफ स्क्वायर ऑफ सम ऑफ टू नंबर्स, देन दिस इज इक्वल टू स्क्वायर ऑफ फर्स्ट नंबर प्लस स्क्वायर ऑफ सेकेंड नंबर प्लस टू टाइम्स फर्स्ट नंबर इंटू सेकेंड नंबर। सो लेट अस टेक एग्जाम्पल। द फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इज 23 स्क्वायर। सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट द स्क्वायर ऑफ 23 विदाउट एक्चुअल मल्टीप्लीकेशन, देन वी कैन राइट 20 एज 20 प्लस 3। सो वी हैव व्हाट वी हैव डन, we have split 23 into 20 plus 3. Now it is in the form of a plus b whole square. Here this 20 is a and this 3 is b. So we will put the value of a and b in this equation, which states that a square plus b square plus 2ab equals to a square, that means 20 square, plus b square, that means 3 square, plus 2 times a into b. A is 20, 2 multiplied by 20 into 3. So now what is 20 square? 20 square is 400. 3 square. 3 square is 9. And 2 into 20, that is 40. 40 into 3, that is 120. So now we have to add this 400 plus 120, 520. 520 plus 9, it is equal to 529. So without actual multiplication, we have split 23 into 20 plus 3, and we use this formula to calculate the square of this number. Let us take another example. Now example number 2, that is 17 square. So what we will do, we will split 17 into 10 plus 7. So always we have to split in such a way that is 17 into 10 plus 7, 18, 10 plus 8, 15, 10 plus 5 in this form. Now it is in the form of a plus b whole square. Here 10 is a and 7 is b. So we will put value of a and b on right hand side, which states that 10 square, that means a square, plus b square, b is 7, 7 square, plus 2 times 10 into 7. That means 2 times AB. Now what is 10 square? 10 square is 100. 7 square, that is 49. And 2 into 7, 14. 14 into 10, 140. So if we add 100, 49 and 140, this becomes 289. So 17 square is 289. So in this form, we can calculate the square of any number. 95, 90 plus 5 whole square, 92, 90 plus 2 whole square. So by using this method, we can calculate the square of any number. Next topic is finding the square of a number when unit digit is 5. So whenever unit digit is 5 and we have to find the square, then it is very simple by using a formula which states that a 5 square. Here a can be any number. If we want to calculate 15 square, then a is 1. if we want to calculate 25 square, then a is 2. So here a is some number from 1 to 9, and this is equal to a into a plus 1 into 100 plus 25. So this is the formula a5, where a is some number and square of a5 is equal to a into a plus 1 multiplied by 100 plus 25. For example, if we want to calculate 25 square, so that means here a is 2. Now what we have to do, we will put the value of a on in RHS, which states that a into a plus 1. What is a? A is 2. So 2 multiplied by a plus 1. What will be a plus 1 if a is 2? 2 plus 1 is 3. Multiply by 100 plus 25. So this will be equal to 3 into 6. 6 into 100. 600 plus 25. This is equal to 625. Example number 2. If we want to calculate 85 square. Now what we have done, we have put the value of a is equal to 8. So 85 square will be equal to a into a plus 1. That means 8 into a plus 1 will be 8 plus 1, that is 9, into 100 plus 25. So 8 into 9 is 72. 72 into 100 is 7200 plus 25. This is equal to 7225. So by using this formula, and we will just put the value of a in RHS, and by this we can calculate the square of any number if the unit digit is 5. So this method is only applicable when the unit digit is 5. Now example number 3, in this case we will take value of a in 2 digits. For example, if we want to calculate 125 square. So now if we compare 125 equal to a5, then this a is equal to 12. So other than 5, all the digits, all the number will be taken as a. Now we will put the value of a in RHS. So this will be equal to a. 12 into a plus 1. A plus 1 will be 12 plus 1, 13. Into 100 plus 25. So what is 12 into 13? It is 156. So 156 into 100, 15600 plus 25. So on adding, this will become 15625. So in this way, we can calculate the square with, and a can be a single digit number, double digit, triple digit, and so on. Next topic is Pythagorean triplet. Pythagorean triplet means if sum of squares of two numbers is equal to square of some another number, then those three numbers form Pythagorean triplet. So what is Pythagorean triplet? If sum of squares of two numbers is equal to square of some another number, then those three numbers form a Pythagorean triplet. For example, 3 square plus 4 square. 3 square is 9 and 4 square is 16. This equals to 25. So now we know that 25 is equal to 5 square. So here we can see that 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 5 square. That means square of two numbers, sum of square of two numbers, that is 3 square plus 4 square, this is equal to 5 square. So this means 3, 4 and 5 forms Pythagorean triplet. So if the sum of squares of two numbers is equal to the square of some third number, then these three numbers forms a Pythagorean triplet. Or we can say that these three numbers 3, 4 and 5 form sides of right triangle. So we have studied some property about right triangle. What is a right triangle? A triangle with angle 90 degree. So in right angle triangle, hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. This is Pythagoras theorem. So if we compare this by this, so here also sum of sides of square, sum of squares of two sides is equal to square of the third side. So this is just same as this. So these three numbers form Pythagorean triplet, or we can say that these three numbers form sides of right triangle. Now the question arises, how to find these three numbers? So for this, for every number, for every natural number, we can find a Pythagorean triplet by using a result I am writing. This result states that for any natural number m, here m is some natural number greater than 1. So this property only holds for natural number which is greater than 1 but not equal to 1. There exist a Pythagorean triplet having members 3 numbers. So for corresponding to m greater than 1, there exist 3 numbers. First is m square minus 1, second is 2m, and third is m square plus 1. So if you are given a number, for any natural number which is greater than 1, we can find a Pythagorean triplet by just putting the value of m in these three numbers. First is m square minus 1, second is 2m, and third is m square plus 1. For example, first example is find Pythagorean triplet for m is equal to 2. So now we have studied that for any natural number m greater than 1, there exists a Pythagorean triplet, that is m square minus 1, m 2m and m square plus 1. So here m is equal to 2, so m square minus 1 is 2 square minus 1, that is 4 minus 1, and 4 minus 1 is 3. Next is 2m. So 2m is equal to 2 multiplied by 2, that is 4. And third is m square plus 1. So m square plus 1, that is 2 square plus 1, this is equal to 4 plus 1, which equals to 5. So here we got 3 numbers, that is 3, 4 and 5. And we know that 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 5 square. So the number on the right hand side will be the largest of all these numbers. So 3 square plus 4 square equal to 5 square. Let us take another example. Find Pythagoras triplet for m is equal to 3. So now we will find Pythagorean triplet corresponding to m is equal to 3. So what we will do? We will change the value of m in the equation. So first is m square minus 1. So number will be 3 square minus 1. This is 9 minus 1, that is 8. Next is 2m. 2 into 3, that is 6. And third is m square plus 1, that is 3 square plus 1, which equals to 9 plus 1, that is 10. So we got 3 numbers, 8, 6, 8 and 10. So now 10 is the largest number among all these, so we will take 10 on the right hand side, and on left hand side the rest of 2 numbers will be written. So 6 square, that is 36, 8 square, that is 64. 36 plus 64 is equal to 10 square, that is 100. Now we will start exercise 6.2. First question is find square of the following numbers. So first number is 32. We have to calculate the value of 32 square. So for calculating we will use the identity which states that a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So now we have to calculate 32 square. So we will split 32 into 30 plus 2 square. So now here the value of a is 30 and value of b is 2. So now we will put value of a and b in the RHS. So first is a square, that means 30 square, plus b square, that means 2 square, plus 2 into ab, that means 2 into 30 into 2. So 30 square is 900, 2 square is 4, and 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 3, 12, 120. So this is equal to 1024. So this was the first part. Second part is 35. So here also we will use the same identity. So 35 square. So we can write 35 as 30 plus 5 square. So now the value of a is 30 and value of b is 5. So this will be equal to a square, that means 30 square plus b square, that means 5 square plus 2 into ab, 2 into 30 into 5. So 30 square is 900, 5 square is 25, and 2 into 5, 10, 10 into 30, 300. So on adding this is equal to 1225. Now we can calculate 35 square by the method we studied in the introduction part, because here the unit digit is 5. So out of these two methods you can use any method. Now third part, 86. So 86 can be written as 80 plus 6 square. So if we compare, this is A and this is B. And this is equal to a square, that means 80 square plus b square, that means 6 square plus 2 multiply ab. A is 80 and b is 6. So what is 80 square? 80 square is 6400. 8 square is 64, and since there is 1 0, on squaring the zeros will become double. 6 square is 36. And 2 into 6, 12. 12 into 8, 96. So this is 960. On adding the answer is 7396. Next is 93. 93 can be written as 90 plus 3 square. So this is A, 90, and B is 3. So this is A square, that means 90 square plus b square, that means 3 square plus 2 into 90 into 3. So 90 square is 8100, 3 square is 9, and 2 into 3, 6, 6 into 9, 54, 540. So on adding the answer is 8649. So now next part is 71. 71 can be written as 70 plus 1 square. So now A is 70 and B is 1. So A square, that means 70 square, plus B square, that means 1 square, plus 2 into 70, that means A into B, 1. So 70 square is 4900, 7 square 49, and 1 0 on squaring will become 2 zeros. Plus 1 plus 2 into 70, 140. So this will be equal to 5041. So last part of first question, 46. 46 can be written as 40 plus 6 square. So this is A, 40, and this is B, that is 6. So this is equal to A square, 40 square plus B square, 6 square plus 2 into A, that means 40 into B, that is 6. So 40 square is 1600, 6 square is 36, and 2 into 6, 12, 12 4 is 48, that means 480. So on adding, this will become 2116. Now the question number 2, find Pythagorean triplet whose one member is 6. So there is a Pythagorean triplet, there are 3 numbers in Pythagorean triplet and one number is given 6. So we have to find the other 2 numbers. So what are the numbers in Pythagorean triplet? First number is m square minus 1, second is 2m, and third is m square plus 1. That means if 6 is the member of this Pythagorean triplet, then this 6 will be either m square minus 1 or 2m or m square plus 1. So we will find what is 6 out of these 3 numbers. So first let us suppose m square minus 1 is 6. So 6 is among these 3 numbers. So first of all we suppose that 6 is equal to m square minus 1. So from here we will take 1 on RHS. So m square will become 7. That means 7 is square of some number. But we know that 7 is not a perfect square. So 7 cannot be square of any number, so this case is not possible. So that means out of these 3 numbers, 6 is not equal to m square minus 1. Now the second number is 2m. So 2m is equal to 6. So from here, if we calculate m, m will be 6 by 2, that is 3. So here we found the value of m. So corresponding to m, what are the members of Pythagorean triplet? M square minus 1, 2m and m square plus 1. So first number, which is equal to m square minus 1. And what is the value of m? M is 3. So 3 square minus 1, 9 minus 1, that is 8. Second number, which is equal to 2m. So 2m, 2 into 3, that is 6. And the third number, this is equal to m square plus 1, that means 3 square plus 1, 9 plus 1, that is 10. So the three numbers are 8, 6 and 10. So we can write 6 square plus 8 square equal to 10 square. Next is 14. Now it is given that 14 is a member of this triplet. So 14 is either of m square minus 1 or 2m or m square plus 1. So first of all we will suppose m square minus 1 is equal to 14. From here m square is 15. 1 will go to RHS. Now we know that 15 is not a perfect square. So there doesn't exist any number m such that its square is 15. So this case is not possible. So this is not possible. So this is not equal to 15. 14. Next is 2m. So 2m is equal to 14. So from here the m is equal to 14 by 2, that is 7. So we got the value of m, that is 7. So the first number which is equal to m square minus 1, and value of m is 7. So 7 square minus 1, that is 49 minus 1, 48. Second number 2m, that means 2 multiply by 7, 14. And the third number m square plus 1, 7 square plus 1, that means 49 plus 1 is equal to 50. So from here we can write that 14 square plus 48 square is equal to 50 square. Third part is 16. So now we will suppose m square minus 1 is equal to 16. From here m square is equal to 17. Again we can see that 17 is not a perfect square. So this case is not possible. Now what is the second number? 2m. 2m is equal to 16. Here m is equal to 16 by 2, that is 8. So corresponding to value m is equal to 8, what is the first number? M square minus 1, that is 8 square minus 1, 64 minus 1, that is 63. Second number 2m, 2 into 8, that is 16. And the third number m square plus 1, so 8 square plus 1, that is 64 plus 1, 65. So we can write 16 square plus 63 square is equal to 65 square. Now the last question of this exercise 18. So now first of all let us suppose m square minus 1 is equal to 18. From here m square is equal to 18 plus 1, that is 19. Again we know that 19 is not a perfect square, so this case is not possible. So next 2m, 2m is equal to 18. So from here m is equal to 18 by 2, that is 9. So corresponding to value m is equal to 9, first number is m square minus 1, that is 9 square minus 1, 81 minus 1, that means 80. Second is 2m, 2 into 9, 18. And the third number m square plus 1, so this will become 9 square plus 1, 81 plus 1 is equal to 82. So here we can write that 18 square plus 80 square is equal to 82 square. So here the exercise is completed. In the next video we will do the introduction part of exercise 6.3. Till then, like, subscribe and share. Thank you.